very first instructional YouTube video. I have never done an instructional YouTube video before. I've shot quite a few of them, but I've never published them because I just didn't have the right camera angles or anything like that. So, but I was kind of excited about this because this is a project that I've been working on for a while. Maybe this will help somebody else with one of these projects as well. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go through opening this box of parts that I just got from Outboard Jets, and it is a Outboard Jet pack that's gonna go on a 60 horse Yamaha. And I have to put it together apparently, because I opened the box, I looked in there, and there's a bunch of pieces. So I'm gonna try to go through and assemble this for you and put it on the motor. I think I'm gonna be able to do this all in one day, since it's already 4 o'clock this afternoon. So San Leandro, California has a company called Outboard Jets, and they pretty much have the whole product monopolized. So here's the place, San Leandro, California. Here's the place. It's called Outboard Jets, been around since the 70s. The Y70 only goes up to 2003, because in 2004, Yamaha made a different shaft, so you have to get a Y70-04, which that's what the model number is for the 04 and up models for the Yamahas. So to start this off, I've already gone through the box. I went through the box and I kind of separated some nuts and bolts and stuff like that to make it a little easier. I really thought that this lower unit was going to come assembled already. Everything, and then you just get it in the mail, and then you just drop the other lower unit and stick this one on, but it didn't. It came all in pieces. So here's the box. It comes like this. Stickers and instructions. So I'm gonna go ahead and lay the camera down and then take everything out and lay it on this table. All right, the big piece first. All right, this big bad boy. This is where your foot goes, on the bottom right here. Your cable assembly for your around here, and this is your exhaust. So this will go down like this when you're going forward, and then when you kick it in reverse, what this does is this shuttles this facing in front of your jet, which it covers this part right here, and it forces it to go into this cup. And now the cup right here is gonna be your thrust. So now your thrust is gonna be coming out of here, and it's gonna be going this way, direction of my thumb, and that's what your reverse is. Okay, so this is the assembly where your shaft's gonna come up through here. And then you're going to have your whole drive system right here for your water pump is going to go right on top of this shaft, and the cup and everything where your impeller goes and all that is going to go right here. This cavity here will feed the water into this system. And then here's a bracket right here, and I think your cabling is going to come down onto this bracket and then go to your control on the side right here. This is your grease fitting. This is how you all you do is stick this back in that zerk fitting right there when you're driving it or right using it. And then when you're done, you always put grease in the grease fitting, get the grease to come out of your end of your hose, and make sure there's no water and everything in your lower unit. Basically, the casing and the bearings and stuff that will actually go to your shaft in your main bearing where your impeller actually mounts to. Okay, so here's your shaft. So here's your drive shaft, and this should spin. There's a bearing on it. So this is going to go up through the bottom and out this hole. And then, there's some little O-rings right there. Little O-rings right there and right there and right there. And there's holes drilled here. I guess water comes up through those holes. This bottom piece is where your impeller is going to mount on the inside of this hole. And that's what's going to be turning in order to spin this circular water in this circular motion to come out the back. And that's what actually, it's basically a really high horsepower blender. Got this spacer here. The spacer's supposedly gonna sit right on here. So the spacer is gonna go on here like this, and that's what mounts to your lower unit. And I have no idea, but it looks like that's a flat piece, and this is a flat piece, so looks like to me that's gonna go on just like this, match those holes up. I guess this makes more sense. Yeah, this makes more sense. This cavity right here is where your impeller housing is going to go for your water pump. And I think you still have access to the bottoms of these. So I think you have, no, I didn't see any nuts in there. I don't know. We got to figure it out. This is blindly with no instructions. All right, let's get some more junk out of here. Some lube. This is the lube they recommend you using, so we're going to lubricate everything with that. Here's the shift cable harness. This is basically going to go on here like this, and this is going to hold your shift cable so you can hold the outside of the shift cable so the cable will move the bracket back and forth for the your forward and reverse. Starting to make a little more sense. This is your part of your impeller or your, so I would imagine this is part of your water pump right here. So this is probably going to go in here like so. Since that notch is cut out, it obviously probably does not go this way because it can't fit. So it's probably going to go in here like this. Then we got these washers here that say chef nut retainer large, and then these are torsional dampering washers, which they are polyurethane washers, and that looks like the cup. Okay, so I went ahead and divided all these out. There are 7 washers in here, I believe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's 7 washers in here. Here we got 2 pins that are the same size, and these 2 little pins are the same size. This is an off-size bolt, and this is an off-size bolt. The only 2 that are different and single bolts, and I don't know what this Teflon pin is for, but we'll find out. We have 4 of these thread with 4 washers. We have 4 of this thread and this size with 4 washers. We have 4 of these size threads, which you have 2 smaller ones and 2 longer ones with 4 washers. We have 4 of this size, which are bigger than these four, these size, with two longer ones and two shorter ones with washers as well. The box is empty. It looks like this is the rest of the parts right here. Everything comes in this rubber plastic. Don't get anything dinged up. Okay, so I took that out. And this is what we got here. We got the foot. We got this coupling with a bevel here. This is where your impeller, I assume this is gonna mount to the bottom. This is gonna go underneath this unit here. It's going to mount to the bottom, and your impeller is going to be on the shaft inside here. Presume this is your impeller. Alright, here's your impeller. This is not a stainless steel impeller. This is an aluminum impeller, and I believe they do make a stainless steel impeller that you can buy as well. It looks like here's a little package. This is probably your keys for the shaft keys. Yep, that's what those are. Those are keys for your shaft right there. There should be a flat side on the shaft where these two flat pieces go. And there is. It's probably right here. There's the flat piece. See that this flat side right here is where your keys are gonna go. I would imagine this big piece here is gonna mount in there like that. Since it's beveled, since this is beveled, I would imagine the shaft's gonna come down and this is gonna sit just off of that, probably a little bit. So we have the whole list of parts here. Impeller, nuts and bolt, or not nuts, impeller, bolts and washers, two bolts, two pins one size, two pins another size, one Teflon pin, seven, I would imagine these are shims or spacer washers, two, this looks like the lock washer that goes on the shaft right here, because it's got two ears on it. I would imagine this is kind of some kind of whatever this torsional damper is. Here's the foot. This is what the foot looks like on the bottom side. This is what the foot looks like on the bottom side. Water is going to actually be going in. This is what's going to run against the bottom of the surface of the lake. Here's an anode right here for corrosion. You got a coupling right here that mounts the foot in the bottom. I would imagine that the impeller is going to go in here. This is the water pump, this is the spacer, and this is the grease, and they're the instructions, and I would imagine this is going to go on here, something like this. This is going to go on here, and that's going to be your water pump housing, and then you got this little bracket, it's going to mount right here. Your shift cable, your forward, neutral, and reverse cable is going to mount to this, and that's what's going to move this cup up and down, giving you reverse or forward. So in the instruction manual, you get this welcome to boating, and they show you a boat on here from 1960, 1970, I don't know, they could have given you another updated picture since they've been making these so long. Basically it goes back and says you want to make sure that the foot on the motor matches, is level or even with the bottom of the boat right here. And they talk about how you can put these fins right here on the bottom of your foot to help stabilize it and less cavitation and all that kind of stuff. So I ain't worried about that right now. Two big old outboard jet stickers. And then you get this selecting a boat, blah, 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 jet size, degrees, blah, 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 everything, RPMs, tilting the motor, height, and all that kind of garbage. But really, as long as you mount the front of this with it's level with the bottom back of the boat. That's really how you set it up, and that's it. You just go from there. And your exploded diagram, which is kind of good, I guess. If you can read a map, I guess you can put this together. However, the instructions here tell you how to put it together with no pictures. So that's why we got this trusty old Harbor Freight Pittsburgh digital caliper is going to help us with the measurement of these bolts. Half inch dowel. Let's see, is this half inch? Let me see this little one. Nope, that's the half inch. The smaller one. The smaller one is half an inch. So we're gonna use that half inch dowel pin on those instructions. So this thing, this digital caliper is gonna help out a lot with these instructions. So we're gonna go from here. The first thing it says though is to take the lower unit off of the other engine. So that's gonna be something we gotta do first. Cause I would imagine since you have to take the whole impeller system for the water cooling off, the water pump basically, since you have to take that off and put it on here, they want you to go ahead and take the lower unit off that of the motor. So we'll do that. So since they give you directions with no pictures, that's kind of my purpose of this video, is to maybe help somebody that can watch this video and know where this stuff goes without having to read all this. Or if you need to take yours apart and you forget how to put it back together, you'll know maybe by assembling this. One good thing about this assembly is this bearing is already pressed in here, inside of here. This bearing is already in there and it's already pressed and it's already ready to go. So all this is just bolt-on stuff. This is just plug and play. You don't have to press the bearing and anything like that. So in order to take this lower unit off, we're going to have to kick this motor up a little bit. Alright, now the shaft should be able to pull straight out right here. It's in neutral, so I think we've got a bolt under here and four bolts on each side. We have two bolts here, two bolts here. Pop this thing off and down this hole, you got a bolt, and this bolt here seems to be a 12 millimeter. Okay, it's gonna take your trim tab off, or your steering tab off. This is to help correct your steering if it pulls one way, if your steering pulls one direction or the other. Alright, there's that. So that long bolt there comes out. And under that bolt, I mean under that, there's two another screw under here. One right here underneath there we'll have to take off. So there's total six, these two, one that holds that on, and then another little one. Screw looks in pretty good shape. That was a 12 millimeter. This is 14 millimeter. Last bolt. because we have to take the speedometer cable. The speedometer cable plugs in. Speedometer cable plugs in right here. It basically just pushes water into a tube, pushes it into your speedometer gauge. Basically, I just cut a tie wrap, and it has a union, and I just took it apart right there. All right, this lower unit should just slide right off. This is a 12 millimeter, and these aren't on, but these are very lightly on because you have a gasket or a seal in between this, in between the two housings. So here we go. Here's where our short bolts and our long bolts. See the difference in the height? Two long ones in the front, two short ones in the back. And oh, this looks like it was not like it was replaced fairly recently, because there's the top. It's in really good shape. Here's the gasket. It looks brand new. It looks like a brand new gasket right there. And there's a shim. There's a shim. There's a cap that covers the impeller. So basically how to get this off is as you go counterclockwise. Oh, well, that's really good. Well, we know it was grease. Well, okay, twist that off. Get the cap out. Cap looks in really good shape. Dang, this is like brand new. I mean, brand spanking new. It doesn't even have hardly any hysteresis in a circular motion. But since I have a new one, I'm just going to go ahead and use the new one. Got a screwdriver. Lift up on this side, spin it. Lift up on this side, spin. Lift up on this side, spin. 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 There it comes. Okay, it is keyed. There's the... It's really good. Really good shape. I'm going to put the new one in, but I'm going to definitely keep this for a spare. So here's your key right here. I was hoping that would just pull right out. I'm going to take this little punch here. Stick it right on top. There it goes. There it is. Okay, and then we can take this gasket and the shim off. Looks in really good shape. So here's what we ended up with off the other motor. So here's the new kit. And if you can tell the difference, new one, old one. This one has a little bit of spinning hysteresis. One has a little bit of a curvature to it. That was the old one. This is the new one, and they look identical, so that's good. And then, wow, a good, we get all the stuff we just took off there. We get a new one of these. new one of these. We get all the bolts, all four of the bolts that we just have over there. We also get new gaskets, an O-ring, and a new one of these plates. I'll remove the water pump assembly all the way down to the stainless steel plate with the gaskets, impeller key, and dowel pins. Okay, the dowel pins, that's probably what these new dowel pins are for right here. But we're gonna use the old ones. So instructions say now to install the jet shaft assembly into the spiral housing locking in place with the four 5/16 18 by 1 bolts with lock washers to 12 pounds torque. So I know that 5/16 is about 7.9 millimeters. I think it's 7.95 millimeters. So I know it's probably, it's not those bolts. That one's the same size, but there's only one of those. Those are too long, and those are too long. So it's probably these four. 7.9, that's 5/16 with four lock washers. So I'm gonna use those, and they're short. I'm gonna turn this upside down and ram the shaft just like it came out of the box. Grab the shaft, stuck this on the edge, and slid this down in here. Now, here's the cool part, is so if you line up one hole, the others don't line up. So I just keep spinning this to that one hole, and those don't line up. And I spin this again until that one lines up, and those don't line up. But when I get to the fourth one, voila, all four of them line up. So it needs to go in a specific way. So I just spun that hole around till I got all four bolts to line up. So it says to put these four bolts in there. So I got the four bolts. And I'm gonna put them inside of here. One, two, three, four. And it says, install the shaft with the four 5/16 inch bolts with lock washers, 12 pounds of torque using grease on the threads. So I took the grease they sent with it. I just took the back cap off. I'm not ready for it to put in a grease gun yet. So I'm just gonna dab some of this on there. Take a screwdriver, flathead, a little grease. Got my torque wrench set to 12 foot-pounds of torque already. I think these are 13 millimeters. All right, found my socket. Those are all hand tight. Bring the camera back to do the torque. Let's little crisscross pattern. That's pretty tight. That's 12. That's 12. That's 12. That's 12. Flip it over and install the water pump assembly on top of the 1 3/8 inch adapter. Okay. Make sure that we got this indention here facing this hole so that when this goes on, it fits in there, although it's going on the motor. So the new water pump kit came with three gaskets, so I'm going to put this gasket on first, and I'm going to put this on next, and then it said the plate, the aluminum plate, which I have a new one for. So here's the aluminum plate. So we had a gasket that went underneath the aluminum plate. I assume that's gonna go on like that. That's more like it. And the aluminum plate. And then the other gasket, which goes on like this. And the housing, oh no, should be a key. Yeah, there's the key. There's the key. So we gotta put the key on with the new impeller. Duh. Notch is lined up just left side of this. Had it upside down. Okay, it's lined up right where this thing is. Tap the top end a little more. All right, it's flush. It's all the way down. Okay. And this thing of dairy goes on there. So we gotta line up this notch right here. That notch right there has to go inside. This slot right here, this piece right here has to go in. So I'm going to turn it up, side down, line that up. Mosquito. And then slot it in. Just like that. So you'll know when you have that lined up right, because now your hole through here is lined perfectly up with the hole, the center there. Now we're just gonna slide this over. Earlier, the pins that this was talking about were these two pins. Out of the old housing. So I'm going to attempt to put these back in. Oh, there goes one perfect. That pin and that pin. Spin this on again. All right. Now we go back to our bolt kit. And it says install the water pump with the key. Remove the propeller drive from the other drive. Lock in place the 5, 16, 18 inch bolts with lock washers. So we got, what did we say the 5 16ths was? 7.95 millimeters. Got these bolts. Those are too big. That's these four. That's these four bolts. And we have the two long ones go in the high spots, and the two short ones go in the low spots. So we'll have two long ones, two short ones. We'll go two short ones, two long ones. Just took a little wiggling it up back and forth to get them into place because that lower gasket wasn't lined up quite right. Alright, there are no torque specs on this, so I'm just going to tighten it up a little bit. One, two, three. Alright, we left off yesterday with install the water pump assembly on top with the 1 3/8 inch thick aluminum adapter and the stainless steel plate. With the gaskets and the dowel pins. And yesterday we figured out that the dowel pins they were talking about were not the lower unit dowel pins, the actual dowel pins that were in the, for the water pump, which we took those off the old one and put them on the new one. Make sure that you install the impeller drive with the key and lock in place with the bolts and grease the threads. And we did all that. So now we are on the larger 3/4 inch adapter plate is attached to the exhaust housing to hold on the jet drive. Number 5 says the large 3/4 inch adapter plate is attached to the exhaust housing to hold the jet drive. A 3/8 by 1 1/2 pin and the front of the plate guides the disconnected shift rod. Two 6x16mm dowels locate the plate. Four M10 35mm bolts with lock washers and one M8 30mm bolt with a lock washer secures it at 22 pounds. Grease the bolt threads and the ends of the pins where it slides in the shift rod. So this says a 3/8 by 1 1/2 pin in the front of the plate guides the disconnected shift rod. So the only pin on here that's 1 1/2 is this this one right here. This Teflon pin. So we're gonna grab that. And the shift rod goes in this space right here on the lower unit of the prop drive. So here's the shift rod. So this is the shift rod here. So I'd imagine that pin's gonna go in on the wide oval, not tapered side, but the wide oval side. So we're gonna stick this in here. Imagine that this is going to go in like this. So it's solid, so I guess you beat it all the way in, or you push it all the way in. I'm gonna put some grease in it. So I took the pin, little Teflon pin, just gonna use this rubber mallet so I don't bang it up too much. It's solid stop right there, so I'm not gonna hit it anymore. Basically just stuck this board in here to keep the motor from turning left and right on me while it's in the up position. Now they didn't say that I needed to seal this, but I'm thinking I want to put some kind of sealer on here. See how hard this is to get back off once I get it on. I mean, worst case scenario, that thing's just gonna leak air or exhaust out of that. But I think I'm gonna go ahead and seal it. So this says that you need to put four M10 35mm bolts with lock washers and one M8 30mm bolt with the lock washer secured in at 22 foot-pounds. Make sure you grease the pins and the Teflon pin that slides into the shift rod. So since we already measured these four bolts, at 35 millimeter. Since we already measured, 35 millimeters, right there's 35 millimeters on the threads, and there's four alike bolts, and they're metric. You can see how tight the threads are, and you have four lock washers. Now, then it says use that one, which we ended up with two single ones here, but there's only one washer left and it does not fit this bolt right here. So this has to be your other pin, other bolt it's talking about. Plus, if you look at the thread pattern, this is way tighter than this. This more than likely is an M thread, and this is your standard thread. So this should read 30 millimeters if we go down to 30. And there's a little notch right here. And when this goes on, that little notch is going to be flush with this flat piece. So that means, that tells me that they want that hole there for a reason. So I'm not going to RTV that. So I'm going to go put some RTV around the outside edge only. Well, I know why they want this little notch left right here. These two holes where the gear assembly goes through are just wide open. There's no seal, no seal or anything. So this whole cavity right here is going to fill up with water. And, oh, well, that's how you pump water up to the, The water goes in here, fills this whole cavity, and then you have the water pump pushes the water up this tube and it goes into your motor. So it's a good thing that I didn't, and I guess that notch is there so when you come out of the water it drains out, you don't have water left in there. Alright, let's see if I can get this lined up without getting this all over us. Alright, there's that. There's the pin in the front, pin in the back. Normally I would just, get all this excess RTV off, but I think it's gonna be fine like that. Now we'll get the bolts. All right, here we go. We got 13 millimeter for the small bolt, and we have 16 millimeter for the larger bolts. So, oh, we got a grizzle. I always forget I have this because I always remember I have it at the end of all my projects, and then I look at the I look at the work table and go, oh, I guess I could have used that after my projects are done. Snug, 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 and one at the back. Snug. All right, this has 22 foot-pounds. Break over. All right. Next. Okay, so we got done with number 5. And number 5 was to put the adapter plate on with the dowel pins in the front and the rear. Put the Teflon guide in for the shift rod. Put the 4 M10 35 millimeter bolts on with washers and 1 M8 30 millimeter bolt on with a lock washer, and they're all tightened down to 22 foot-pounds of torque with grease on the threads. And I added an extra thing. I put RTV all the way around the shift plate, except for that one little spot, except for that small little spot right there, because this whole unit here fills up with water, and when it does, it pumps the water up into as you can see, this whole chamber will fill up with water. The water fills into the water pump, then this impeller spins, and then it goes up that tube and it goes into your engine to cool your engine. So now we're on step 6. 4 bolts with lock washers that are 3/8, 16, and 1 3/8, 16, 1 1/4 inch bolt from the above rear are used. Select the lower bolt lengths to suit the different counter board depths so that all bolts enter the adapter plate at the same depth. All right. So the 2 dowel pins we used up here on the flat plate were the 2 smaller ones, which I didn't use the brand new ones. I used the other ones off the old lower unit. So now we're gonna have 2 extra dowel pins. So here they are, the 2 extra dowel pins are these. All right, so they don't fall out. I'm gonna put a little grease on the end of these. Well, I said a little. One goes in here, and one goes in here, because that's the only holes that are fit, that they'll fit in. All right, got the dowel pins in, and pretty sure you always put grease on the end of that shaft. grease the bolt threads, drive shaft spline generously, and rubber water tube pilot guide to put the jet into place. Tighten your 5 bolts. Okay, now we need to find the bolts. So the only bolts we have left are these 4. Right here, and it says make sure long ones go in the deeper holes and your short ones go in the into the shallower holes. So now we have to determine where these bolts go. All right, so we have to figure out where our long bolts go and our short bolts go. So this is flat, so we can't determine here. Let's go to see the jet drive. Okay, so I don't know if you can see it or not. These 2 front holes are raised up higher than these 2 bottom holes. So I would imagine our longer bolts are going to go in the front. Okay, so let's put these in the front and we'll put the shorter bolts. Here, and then we'll come over here and we'll look. And we have an even thread distance from the plate. So the short bolts go in the back, or actually this would be the front. And our long bolts go in the back.
All right, now we know where
the bolts go. Going to pre-lube the shaft where the water pump hose goes into. Grease the shaft generously. Going to grease the shaft generously. Is that generous enough? Here's a question. Do we need any RTV on this plate? Sure doesn't say. So I'm not gonna put any on there. This could get complicated. Basically, I'm just trying to get the shaft to go either up or down or left or right and right until it connects. Okay. Well, that's not working, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to spin the shaft a little bit down here. Just a little at a time to see if... Well, there it goes. Okay, so I think the spline of the shaft went in. Now I just gotta wiggle it around till I get the water pump hose to connect. And you figured this by wiggling this around. Whoa, there it goes. Okay. Up the pins. There they are. Okay, I need to put 1 bolt in. I'm trying to do this with the camera and not dropping the lower unit off of here. So the long bolts go in the back. That one's not greased. I'm just putting this bolt in here until I can get the rest of the bolts greased and this thing don't fall out. This little bolt that goes in the back up here is a 13 millimeter. We're gonna put that one in first.
Just gotta make sure I pull that other bolt out.
My bad. That hole is no longer used. Alright, so putting this, it's not 13. All these bolts that are going in the last are 15 millimeter. Okay, we got that in there. Now we're gonna take this bolt out so I can put some grease on it. So here's the bolt that we put on the top. This one here is no longer used. It just put the cap back on. That one's not tight yet. I just put that on there so this thing wouldn't fall off while I stick these on. Long ones go here, short ones go down here. Let me make sure on the torque. foot-pounds of torque. 22 foot-pounds of torque, which is the last setting we used in the last bolts, and it is still set at 22. These are 11 millimeter. This is where your shift cable is going to go. Okay. Cable's going to go mount to the outside, so I'm going to put some grease on these. Started. Eleven millimeter. I'm not going to tighten that up too tight because there is a slot in here and this has a little bit of play. So I would imagine that's more of a cable adjustment. So I'm just going to put it in the center, kind of snug them down just a hair. Until it gets on the motor, which is a whole nother project. Till the motor gets on the boat, which is a whole nother project. Okay, those are good. Make sure those don't fly off of there. Vibration. It says, next, install the impeller, number 7. Grease the shaft threads, key, and impeller bore. So we're going to take the nut off, grease the spline, the threads. We're also going to grease the inside of this shaft here. And then it wants us to, here are the two keys that came inside of that plastic piece. Those are the keys. Because see, there's a notched area right here. And that notched area, your key, fits inside that notched area, which creates a half circular shape with a flat spot. And the darn thing is so long that it takes two keys. So we're going to place the two keys inside of there like this. Alright, so and it says place the plastic sleeve inside the impeller. Hold the key with the nose of the impeller with your forefinger and slide it onto the shaft. Install the 8 shim washers and nut retainer on the shaft up against the impeller and bring the nut up against snug by hand. Be careful that the retainer does not fall into the threaded groove and jam the nut. So we need to grease the threads, grease the key, and grease the impeller bore. Place the plastic sleeve inside the impeller, hold the key in the nose of the impeller with your forefinger and slide onto the drive shaft. If you see the shaft, there's a flat side right there. Round, flat side. So with the key inside of that shaft, you have this butted up to there. That little bump right there goes in that little slot, and that's what actually, when the shaft spins, that's what creates that's what allows this to spin on it as well. Now that we got it all greased up, got the key all greased up rather. I don't know if that's too much or not. So we got all of them, so we gotta see the flat side. Let's take some of this grease off. And all the threads. Alright. And then it says the bore. Getting grease in there. Go from both sides. Now what the instructions do not say is if it goes like this or if it goes like this. But I'm gonna guess that this piece right here, which I don't know if I need grease on this or not, but I'm putting some on there anyway. Can't hurt, right? It's just grease. I'm pretty sure that it's not supposed to touch that. And another thing I'm gonna do is, we got plenty of grease. I'm gonna put some in here. On top of this bearing, even though it's probably gonna spin it off with centrifugal force, I just would like to know that I did that just to say I did. Alright, I'm gonna put the key in. Put that there. Flat side goes this way. Okay. Keys in. Plastic piece came out. Excess grease. Well, I'm glad I called because I wanted to get this right the first time. Here is what I left with you. And I had put this bolt on. So I took the bolt off. And there's the key. And there is the... it's just being held on right now with the grease. It's just sitting there. So, nowhere in these directions right here does it say anything about torsion dampener or anything like that. So I called and I figured out where all this stuff goes. So I was left with this little bag, these 7 washers, and this bag, which is the retainer nut, obviously. So the instructions over here say, slide the impeller on, and it says right here, install 8 shim washers and retainer nut. Well, there's only 7 metal washers here, and here's a retainer nut. So I didn't know if that meant 7 and 1 is 8, or it meant 8 and 1 is 9. So I had this little bag over here. It says torsion dampener, and what it came with was, is it came with a plastic washer. It actually came with 2 plastic washers and this little cup. So I called and he said, put the impeller on, put the key in, this goes on first, this goes on second. These, so that's the 8th washer. These 7 washers go on, and then your retaining clip goes on. So let's go do that. Got this cap. It goes on like this. This is the 8th washer. This little plastic one goes on like that. And the grease helps it stay on. That's good. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, plus the plastic one is 8. Then you have the retainer clip. Just to do this again. Now I'm gonna go backwards just to show you. Nut. Retainer clip. Seven metal washers. Seven metal washers. One clear washer. And this cap. So in reverse order, this torsion cap facing down goes up against that plastic washer. Next. Seven metal washers. Keyed retainer washer. And the nut. hand tight. Okay, so we got the cap on with the plastic washer, 7 metal washers, retainer clip, and the nut. And it says hand tight, so that's hand tight. Then it says, then bump the nut with a wrench. If the ears of the retainer clip do not line up with the flats on the nut, spin the nut off, turn the retaining clip over, and tighten the nut again. In one of these two positions, you will have to align and fold the ears of the nut against. Stop. So bump the nut with a wrench. If the ears of the retaining clip do not match the flat sides on the nut, then take the nut off, take the retaining clip out, spin or turn the retaining clip over, put the nut back on, and in one of these two positions you'll have alignment and can fold the ears up against the nut. So evidently, it looks if I tighten this, those ears aren't gonna line up. So I'll probably need to go ahead and spin that off. Turn the retaining clip upside down and then bump it with the wrench. All right, we got a wrench. I'm gonna spin this off. Hey, stay on there. Okay. Nut back on. Okay, that's hand tight. Bump it with the wrench. Now you can see those are gonna line up right. Alright, nut. Okay. Bump this. Okay, align that up. That's bumped. All right, got a pair of these channel locks. Just going to grab one edge here, grab that flat, bring that up against there. Grab this flat, bring that side up to there. Okay. So now we have the retaining clip bent over on both sides. All right. GoPro, stop recording. It says, when after use with gravel and sand, the blade clearance becomes more than 1/32 inch between the impeller edge and the intake. The water intake, one or more of the stainless steel shims can be transferred from the bottom stack to the top of the impeller, which moves the impeller down into the tapered casing a little bit more to reduce the clearance. Shims should never be placed above the impeller on new installations because there is no wear unless the blade clearance exceeds 1/32 inch. Insufficient blade clearance will do more harm than good for any performance gains it might provide. So since this is new, all the shims are on the bottom. Place the intake casing in the position with the lower end at the rear and tighten the 6 nuts to 12 foot-pounds. No lock washers are needed. Grease the threads. So this came tie wrapped on here. So this came tie wrapped on here. Now I don't know if it has to go on that way, but I'm gonna put it on just like it is tie wrapped. Not moving anything. Just gonna put one on so I don't fall.
I remember the guy telling me that when you put this on, make sure that all these bolts go on evenly. And I'm gonna have to guess at this one on the torque because I don't have an open end torque. Oh, never mind. I can use a short socket. GoPro, stop recording. That's done. Well, the last step. So right here is the lubrication label. It says, after the day's use, pull the hose coupling straight off to expose the grease fitting. Pump in just enough grease to purge the hose of any moisture. Reconnect the coupling. Use a water-resistant NLGI number 2 lubricant, which goes in right here. So we're gonna pump this new grease into the unit until it comes out this purge hose. Which I would imagine probably gonna take, well, that's probably enough. It was some air. See that air? Now there's no more grease. So, double that over and hit it again. Go slow. All right. Got solid grease, still got some pressure. Would call that good. And now if you want to test run it, you take this screw out right here, you put you a special fitting in that hooks up to your water hose, turn your water on just a little bit, start the motor, increase your water flow after the motor's already running, so that way you don't blow any hoses or anything off inside the engine. And I would call this done. This is the first time I've ever done this. I just read the directions with no pictures. Seems like it went on. Okay. The next project is going to be to get this motor on the boat. It's on the 100th subscriber is invited to go on either one of our river trips down on the Rio Grande or go down to Port Aransas and do some coast fishing. We might even go on a pig hunt, bow hunt. The 100th subscriber
for the 500th subscriber that chance, and I'm going to offer the 1,000th subscriber that chance. You know, a lot of people don't get a chance to go outdoors and do anything like this. And I just really enjoy the outdoors, just like a lot of people. But hopefully this will help somebody with one of these, because I know there's not a whole lot of information out there for a lot of people. And if you ever go rebuild one of these, just make sure that you do everything in reverse order when you put it back together. Every time you take something apart, line it out in a line on how you're taking it apart. And you know, video it. Video it's good, because you can always go back and go, oh, I remember I took this piece off of here, or I moved that screw over here, or put that bolt over there, or I mentioned that I put these in a certain bowl or in a certain baggie or something like that. We'll talk to you later. I appreciate you watching. If you want to, hit the subscribe button. If you don't want to, I appreciate you watching. I just hope this video helps somebody in the long run. Out.